shaking my fist at the heavens, my lifetime pastime. But now no more natural light shines, flatline. Just as I was dissing his name, I'm hit with the flames as my soul left my physical frame. Frightened, my senses heightened, defenseless against this relentless lightning. A stampede of thunderclaps, I can't breathe, it's like I'm running laps with my lung collapse. I can't leave, I'm fucking trapped. Meanwhile, I am no longer senile. The life I lived in the body, that feels like the dream now. And I've awakened to a real life nightmare. It's quite clear, no use putting up a fight here. My destiny is sealed. A true catastrophe with future agonies that have yet to be revealed. And that thought alone is such a blow to me, it's terrible. Cause what I'm feeling right now is totally unbearable. I'm disembodied, met my worst fear mentally. Every second like a year, every year a century. No one that I can call. I'm crushed under a wall of holy fury, amazed by the justice of it all. Getting what I deserve, in fact my soul is burning black. I crossed over the threshold, never to be saved. Eternal is the furnace and it ain't no turning back. Oh God, just let me send my fam a letter from the grave.
Having lunged fist first into a fixed state of horror and agony, Mr. Michaels attempts to gather his bearings. As he scrambles to find a way to warn his family, little does he know that, as sincere as he may be, the following efforts are sadly in vain.
Oh God, I'm in agony right now. I'm in agony in this fire. Please, can I just warn my family, please? Can I just warn my family? Just let me go back. If I can't go back, just let me write them a letter. Let me dictate it. My parents, my sisters, my cousins, my nieces, friends, co-workers, everybody needs to read this. You probably thinking I'm in heaven smiling down upon you, but it's not true. I'm writing this now to warn you. I'm serious, wish I could put a gun to your face. Whatever it takes to make you listen, don't come to this place. I made tons of mistakes when I was there with y'all, certainly. The worst by far was not preparing for eternity. It's crazy, I don't even know how to tell y'all, but I'm in hell, y'all. And I know it's upsetting to hear, it's upsetting to be here, but I write so you get it and see clear. I don't have all the answers, I grope for more, but there are a couple of things that I know for sure. Reincarnation is a lie, there's no such thing as Satan lie. Getting to heaven through meditation, that's a lie. Yo, it's vital we build, homicidal I feel, your pride will be killed. The God of the Bible is real, y'all know. I ain't read the Bible a day in my life, but he's the one who's inflicting all my pain and my strife. So get a Bible and read it, whatever you read, believe it. After believe in, eat it, sleep it, and breathe it. There's much more to this man Jesus. Observe the story, and I can tell you that there's no such thing as purgatory. What I wouldn't give to have your opportunity. I see my pride is ruining me, ignoring God is lunacy. There's no comfort, all shame, no peace. There's no slumber, all pain, it don't cease. So don't be lax when attack with distractions. The fashions and attractions had me relaxing. Now I'm awake for the first time ever, but from the goodness of God's works I'm severed. Regretting all the tracks that I threw in the trash, regretting moving fast in pursuit of the cash, regretting spending all my life trusting myself, regretting not reading the Bible up on my shelf, regretting all the stuff in life that had me caught up, regretting switching the subject when Christ was brought up, regretting not going to church when my friends invited me, regretting believing.